evening and welcome to yet another program of InterFace Gambia's profile show. This is the second edition, and tonight we have one of Gambia's best and Gambia's own music producer, commonly known as Saul Sowe. Suleiman Sowe has been in the music scene in the United Kingdom and in the Gambia for over 19 years, and he's well respected. Welcome, Saul, to our show.
Thank you, I'm glad to be here.
So, to begin with, you've been in the music industry for quite a while now, almost two decades, 19 years. You started here in the United Kingdom, or from Banjul. But let's start from your days here, early when you were DJing. Take us back to those years. How was it like?
Well, 19 years, it sounds a long time. During the 19 years, it all started way back in 1992. I was a student then, and I have a group of friends who used to come to my house, and then we share music together. We always have passion for music in our early days. And from then on, I didn't know that I have this hidden talent, which was DJing. When I started playing it in my house, we organized different house parties, and when I start playing, people enjoy it more than I do. Wow. This is something that I need to check into and take it to another level. This is when we started organizing Sunday pubs. Mm-hmm. We have our elves who were here before organizing.
Okay.
What they were doing, they normally adopted to the European culture. Mm-hmm. And every party that we go to, you have this, we have to dress European, you have to look smart and everything else. It's all nice. But, I think there was something missing. Mm-hmm. So when I start this Sunday pub, if I remember, it's a place called American Corner.
Okay.
I know people who've been here that long can remember American Corner. I think that's in Morning Lane. If you talk to Silva, I think, he's that old.
Yes, so because when I was doing my research, he actually told me that during your DJing days, if you do not play, people don't enjoy. And it seemed you had some things that you were doing with the machine, with the recorder and the players that make people dance, especially the Naga sections.
Yeah, I think it was new to the Gambian community here before then, because I think they never had that. And during that time, I take my time and research on what can I do, musically, to excite the Senegambian community and, of course, involve other communities at large. But firstly, we need to do something to bring this togetherness, mm-hmm. And then make it permanent and also excite them with good music. Like I said, I didn't know that I have this hidden talent. But, judging by the crowd's reaction all the time, mm-hmm. Tells me that, so your hands have something special. So try and work at it and then develop it and take it to another level.
Okay.
And this is how it started, Morning Lane.
Morning Lane, from DJing days. Now, you graduated from being a DJ to a promoter.
Yeah.
What inspired you to do that?
Well,
because at the time, if I may come in here, there were some people who were promoting, for instance, Waka Jain, and then you decided to jump in the promotion business as well with them. What was the motive?
Well, point of correction there. Mm-hmm. Waka was promoting in Gambia by then,
okay.
When I was doing DJing. So in my time, in the early days of 1992-1993, Waka was actually in Gambia.
Okay.
So when all this was actually started, mm-hmm. he was in here.
Okay.
So actually when we moved to the, when Morning Lane, we actually, the crowd was too much that, we did not fit in the same place anymore, so we have to move it somewhere else.
You need a bigger venue.
Because the crowd was bigger. So when we moved to this place, I think it's Mayor Street.
In Hackney Stable.
I think it's Mayor Street. When we moved to Mayor Street, and that place, if I may recall, it's called Virgins. Correct me if I am wrong, but I think the place was called, it's 19 years ago, so, yeah. You know, I cannot remember all venues, but I think that's where the excitement really kicks on, because that's when I link up with Waka, and we actually link up even before he actually come back to this country, because me and another promoter called Jack Gomez. There's only one promoter that I met here that I know. That was Jack Gomez. I'm sorry, and Musa Jo, my great uncle. You know, the two of them were great promoters who used to promote Baba Mal and other top African artists. They were not so much into Gambian things. They were promoting more African artists in the other side of Africa, like Baba Mal. They used to work with Kofi Olomide and all these other top African artists. But coming back to the story, Mayor Street, me and Waka, we connected with Jack Gomez. I knew Waka a long time before that, but you know, we connected via Jack Gomez. That was 1992. So we decided to do a festival in Gambia, which we call Semester Festival.
Okay.
By then, Waka have a shop in Gambia, and he was a promoter in Gambia. So I said, why not? We bring all of us in under one umbrella and make this happen. And this is how it happens. Okay. So we went and do this Semester Festival in Gambia, and it was successful, which we have all this.
Semester is those who live in the European countries, in England,
yes,
or in the United States or somewhere around Europe,
yes,
go back home for holidays. Those are the people you call semesters.
So that's where the name comes
from. So it's a homecoming festival that you had for people living abroad.
Exactly. Okay. It was a homecoming festival that, you know, we all enjoyed. And it was a fantastic period, I must say. And it was exciting, because what happens is this was the first time that, you know, I have the taste of promotion properly.
Okay.
This was way back in.
And that was good money, and then you continued.
Well, I was in, there's never good money at that time, but the passion and excitement, you know, actually, that actually drives me to do more. And actually, when we did that Semester Festival, and that's when we bring Lemzo Jamano, Kinelam, Maslow, and all these top artists to the Independence Stadium, and it was jam-packed. It was really big, and it was very successful. And that was my first experience outside the UK doing a promotion. And when we come back, right, with that excitement and everything else, I said to Waka, why don't you join me? And then we continue what I already started at American Corner. So we can continue doing it at Virgins.
Okay.
So, and the two of us together, we start to build a strong partnership.
Okay.
Yeah. I was very strong in DJing. He was very strong in promotion.
Promoting, okay.
So
Everybody has their strength, and then coming together will be much bigger and better.
Yeah, it was. It was exciting times for the Gambian community here, because Waka was very good in organizing things back then, and I was very good playing music. Although he will claim that he was a good DJ, but I can assure you, you know, we learn from each other. You see, you know, I learned certain techniques from him, and he certainly learned a lot from me. So, and the two of us, we actually pulled it off for about 5 years, working together and building up that carnival atmosphere and everything else.
Yeah.
And this is how it started here.
Yeah, okay. Talking about carnivals, we come to the Senegambia cultural event that we call in the Gambia cultural carnival that we have in London as well. So I'm made to understand that you're one of those who actually were pioneers, even though there were some elders, like you mentioned earlier, there were some people doing similar things in the past who were doing it. But at some point, for some reason, it got stuck, and you had to pick it up along with friends. Who are those people that pushed it from that level where it was before with the elders to the present day situation?
Yeah, I must pay tribute to the people who were here before and started the whole thing, who is Mr. My great uncle, Brian Jeng, and also Uncle Modunjai. These people, they have and there are a whole host of other people, but they were the leaders then. Because there were Uncle Baikor, and you have Uncle Alaji Jain, and all of these people play a vital role in bringing the community together. And this is where it all started, you know, and I pay tribute to these people because they are the ones who paved the way for us, actually, for us to be to able to do what we did. And history is on the right side with them, and I hope our younger generation will judge us as history. To be on the right side with us as well. Yeah, and you know, 1994, if I may remember, we organized a cultural festival with Uncle Brian Jeng. He was the pioneer then. And I remember we invited Keba Telo, Mas Low, and we have this Galadina. Yusuf Mboup was just rising,
a musician
called Yusuf Mboup, and we have Tata Dinding, who graced the occasion as well. During that time, we did it at London Fields, and the whole Gambian community then, you know, enjoyed this award. But you know, organizing these events is not easy. You know, to sustain it is another thing, because they did their utter best to bring us together, and then to their capacity with what they did, and they did fantastically well around the time, because I know how difficult it was. So it happened, and it kicks on, and then I learned from them as well, and it was an other added bonus on my side to actually take it to the next level.
Okay. All right, we'll take a break for now, and when we return, we shall talk about the Gambia promoting music promoting business, the state of it at this stage, and also what are the issues that are actually in the promotion business in the, our community, and how Saul thinks that can be solved. We will also speak to some other individuals that he's mentioned in the discussion, and so Mane is one of those who we really like to say something about Saul. So we hear from them, and we'll be returning in the studio and speak with Saul on more of what he's been doing in the Gambia and also what is coming up.
Before I go any further, I would like to say hello and congratulating InterFace Gambia for the good work that they're doing, and to just tell them to keep it up. Lamin, if you ask me anything about Saul, Suleiman, as I call him, Saul, he is a friend, but more of a brother. It seems we are blood brothers. Me and him, we go back a very, very long way. It started with his elder brother, Babu Sowe. They share the same father. If I remember in my life, he is the only one I have ever shared a towel, bath towel with. We used to sleep in the same bed back home. I used to live at 40, and he was at number 39 primate. Since I came to this country, me and Saul, we've always been close, and everybody knows that. And I'm always supportive of whatever he is in, whatever he's doing. He started his career as a DJ, and there's something as people don't know, Saul is a qualified chef.
Wow.
Yes. Before the DJ, actually, he went to school, and he's a qualified chef, and people don't really know this. It will be interesting. Some will say, oh yeah, if he makes a breakfast for you, Lamin, you'll be licking your fingers.
Well, we have to get Saul on that at some point, because if you mentioned breakfast, that is definitely making my palate wet at the moment.
Continuing on to that, when he started his DJing career, probably I think I was not in the country in the first year or so, but when I came, when we locked hands and started being together, because we know each other from Banjul, Jam Senegal. I used to go to Jam Senegal all the time. He's a very dedicated musician and he loves his music. And I can tell you where he is now, it was a vision. During his DJing career, if I say he's the best, I might be biased. People will say, oh, friend, I'm like,
but you're allowed to say.
Yeah, but definitely.
Is he the best that you've seen? Because you've been in the Senegambian music scene for a while now. How high, on a scale of 10, 1 to 10, how high would you put Soul's DJ talents and DJ skills?
It's very, very difficult, but definitely, I think I'll give him 10 plus. And I'll give Ibra very close to Saul,
because
he's another good DJ. But definitely, Saul, during his time, people reckon he was the number one DJ. And he was very good, but we have very good Gambian DJs as well.
Yeah. From his DJing part, the promotion bit, you were also beside him, giving him, because you know a lot of people in the community giving him contacts and also doing the legwork for him, basically, I think.
Yeah, that's very true. As everybody knows me, I'm a...
man of the people.
Yeah, I'm not a promoter, but I'm a promoter supporter.
Mm-hmm.
Even Saul was my main guy. I always support him, but that does not prevent me from supporting other promoters. And so, because I have that rapport with the people, and because when there's a ditch, I'm there. When there's Nginti, I'm there. And be nice to people.
When there's a funeral or there's a naming ceremony or wedding,
yeah.
Any good or bad program.
Yeah, I'm there. Sometimes you have your butut. You give it to them. Sometimes you don't have. You just go there and your moral support, which is very important. And yeah, I was very supportive of Saul and ideas as well. We'll sit down and say, boy, I'm thinking of doing this. This is what I want to go. How are we going to go to? How are we going to attack it? Then we sit down and crack our brains. Even the DJ will sit down and say, hey, boy, Bini don't call dog feed. Then you started here, you know, even the music will just go, oh, they like this one. No, they don't like. Then we argue on it.
Mm-hmm.
And during his, getting the artist, the promoter bit, most of the time, well, I would say all the time, we'll sit down. I'll know for in advance what's coming, what's going to happen. Then we'll devise a plan. Oh, boy, I'll go here, you go there. This is happening, let's go and hit here. And we used to go on foot, drive our cars and go to people's houses, talk to them nicely, drop the flyers when the tickets are here. You know, Gambians, we love for somebody to bring it, go and give it to them.
Yeah.
Don't wait for people to come for it. You go and meet them and it's like comfort. They don't have to pay bus fare or taxi to go and buy a ticket, which is very helpful. Sometimes you even offer them a lift going to the...
that's marketing for you.
Exactly, that's where it is. That's the Gambian people. They just want somebody to go and give it to them right at their doorstep. And yeah, it was difficult. Showbiz is not easy. There are things I might not be able to discuss, but at the height of it, I even had some slight injuries. So a brother, Sheriff, would know, or you might have heard about it, that something happened in a town in Birmingham, blah, blah. And it was Saul's program, and so was this thing. It was not easy, but alhamdulillah, he managed to push through and do his shows. And at the back of his mind still, he was planning what he's doing now.
Okay. Yeah. Now, Saul is also known in the community as someone who speaks his mind, and most of the time he runs into confrontation with people. You know him for a while. Is he someone that you can say, Defabare Affair, meaning somebody who is really a hot-tempered guy and who doesn't take no for an answer at some point, and he speaks his mind all the time and normally gets into trouble with people? Is he the kind of person?
Lamin, I think that comes with success. And our community, they do not want anybody who will say the truth, like what digger, to put it bluntly.
Say it as it is.
Yes, say it as it is. And one thing about Saul, he is a bit hot-tempered. I know him very well. Even me and him will argue, but constructive one. We'll argue and push and pull, and the missus will get in between and say, no, all of you are not right, blah, 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 blah. He's not hot-tempered. One thing he doesn't like, and nobody likes it, even me, I don't like it, for somebody to belittle you. as somebody to see you are doing good instead of giving you credit and they try to bring you down, which is a small problem in our community. What we say in Wolof language, dañ gum yalla, but at the same time gumun yalla. What Lamin should have, Lamin will have. What answer should have, answer nobody can do. And if you say that you're gonna defy the greatest, the most powerful, then you have a problem. Saul is a little bit hot-tempered, but he doesn't like anybody to belittle him. He doesn't say, he doesn't involve in what is not. You'll never go and see or hear there's a Saul Mawahli. No. He'll do his business and do his thing privately. He'll discuss with those he's supposed to discuss. Some people will see it as he's hot-tempered. That's our Gambian nature. If you don't take nonsense and you don't involve people and you say the truth and know what you want in life and fighting for that, they'll say, oh, he's selfish. He only thinks of himself. He doesn't help people and blah, blah. But he's not hot-tempered.
Mm. Yeah. Can you tell us what is his greatest moment? How, when you normally be with him all the time, can you pinpoint one or two occasions where you say, this is the moment that he was at his best, at his happiest moment, or this was the moment when he was at his lowest? Can you remember those times?
Wow, that's a difficult one.
Just give us one.
Yeah, that's a very difficult one. Well, I would say the birth of his first daughter. I was there. I was at Ngente, and for a man to say that, yes, this is from me.
It was emotional for him.
Yes.
At my,
yeah, and
I would imagine for anyone else.
Yes, even me, he was extremely happy. And the second one, I would say the birth of his son. Yeah, for, because you know what we say and it just, well, it's not really necessary. But the birth of his son, Saul Fraser Jr., as I call him, was a very proud moment for him as well. And achieving what he's doing now exactly, signing the contract. When the contract was signed, we are here together. And he was so, so happy that he's been given license to go open up a radio station in England. And I was very emotional that, wow, my man is going, I'm going to lose him. He was very, very happy.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then those happy moments when you used to go to the nightclub and do your dancing. I understand you're one of those who can do mula checking too much. Very well indeed.
Yes, Lamin.
Was he one of those light-footed DJs who would play? And of course, people are jumping, he will leave his desk and go and join them.
Believe me, it's difficult to see him dance, but he is the best dancer among us all.
Despite the long legs.
That's what makes it even better. I have a video which somebody has to pay millions of pounds to show it.
No, I'm sure our viewers will want to see that video where Saul was doing his mula checking. Or what was it then? Was it mula checking by then? Was
not
Chebujen, maybe.
Yeah, well, I would say mula checking. That was this Lemzo
Jamal thing.
Yeah, Gende, Damaya Double Velo.
I think we have to show that, sir. We're really sorry, Saul. We will have to show this to the people because it's too exciting to leave it. And you also have a lot of photos, pictures that you share with Saul. We can have a look at some of those photos that Ansu and Saul saw during his DJ days. We will be showing that. You can see that them on the screen at the moment. There in one of the photos, Ansu, you are in there in a white gown and standing beside Saul when he was playing music. And you can remember what that occasion was.
That one, I'm very happy and to say, and I'll never remember, I'll never forget that one. That was my wedding with my wife, Aji Ansu, as they call her. Because nobody knew how Aji Saul had surname. That was my wedding. I think it was in 2003. Yeah, it was in 2003. And as always, Saul was supportive. He was there. And in those days, I think he had a program actually, but that person's program has to go when my date was made. And the music I had the music he played that day and the way he did it, the collaboration, no stopping, and
beaucoup de façon.
It was one of the best. But well, come on, it's Ansu and Saul and Ansu's wedding. Saul will do anything extraordinary. And okay. Normally when he goes out to this wedding, he will put on a t-shirt and stuff. But you'll see on that particular one, he had a proper African attire.
And I can even see some gold chain around his neck. Yeah, you call them Lingen spider.
That was the bling bling time. Yeah, that was the bling bling days. Well, not everybody has to wear it, but it was like a fashion that you have your silver or your gold chain.
Yeah.
Around your neck all the time, 24/7.
You also have a number of photos that Saul's early days as a young man, which are quite interesting photos. I'm sure he will not forgive you for showing us, but we will show them. Saul's photos during his younger and early days, tall, lanky chap. You can see some of the pictures that Ansu's, by courtesy of Ansu's Mane, was giving us also for us to know really who Solso really is from the early days up to this point. We've heard from Ajimaka. We're also hearing from Ansu Mane. He's been a very good friend of Saul for a long time, from Gambia up to the United Kingdom, and even when he went back to the Gambia to do his thing in the Gambia. And Ansu, any last word that you want to give out to our viewers and let them know, I mean, who this guy is, Saul Saul? He's not only a promoter, I understand, but also he's a person, a family person, you know.
The only thing I would say for people, we have to notice, or let's wish good to our people who are doing well. And in our community, we like that. So if you look where Saul started, doing this DJing, promoting, and where he is now, you have to give them credit. Well, we have a lot of Gambians like him who started from scratch, and eventually they're here. And we're still more than close. When I'm in Gambia, I'm like a VIP. Anywhere I'm going, Saul will pick me
up. You are VIP. Yeah. You are VIP.
So Saul will come and pick me up, will drive me, pick me. Oh boy, where are you? I'm coming, wait for me, pick me up, and we go to his office, and the staff will look at me, oh, he clear Ansu. So, oh yeah, Ansu. And it's very nice of that. Then you'll feel, oh, your friend is talking behind your back, but in only good times. They must have heard what went on between Ansu and Saul. I can only wish him the best, and I think the sky is the limit for him. He can. So if he wants something, he'll fight for it. He'll go for it. And he's very single-minded. And one good thing in life, Lamin, is a good listener. Listen to especially your close people, because they'll only wish good for you. And he has a very dedicated, because to be in Gambia and do what you are doing, you must have somebody, a very dedicated wife, who's in the United Kingdom studying. Everybody knows that. And if you have that support, and you have the support of your family and friends, the most important one, your mom, I mean, anywhere you want to go, anything you want in this world, you'll get it.
Okay. All right, thank you very much, Ansu. It's a pleasure to have you on the chairs to explain little thing or one or two things about Saul, who is our guest, who we are profiling on our show. I'm sure at some point we will bring Ansu here to sit on the chair himself, and we will be profiling him as well, because he's one of those people in the diaspora, in the Senegambian diaspora, in the United Kingdom, who really have been doing very well in terms of bringing the society together and having friendship, giving people advice, people like myself and other people. So many other people around Serif, and you know, the list goes on. And we will bring him down here and also speak to you about Ansu. Who is Ansu? And Ansu Mane, I call him Kewoltema Kanuleng, Jumfaluleng Ansu Mane. Well, I've leave that to some of my Maninka listeners to be able to decipher that. But Ansu is one of those great men among men. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Lord.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. Bye.
InterFace Gambia TV 3 years anniversary dinner dance and award ceremony. The event is to celebrate another year of existence in the TV industry and award individuals, business and companies that have done well in our community. It's a three-course meal, black tie, New Year's Eve party, where Senegambian glamour and entertainment will be in abundance. Venue is at the Royal Regency Hall, number 501 High Street, North Eastham, London. Commencing 8 p.m. to 2 a.m. Tickets, online bookings only. VIP, £45. Ordinary, £35. Please note, dinner is served at 9:30 p.m. and the event will commence on time. For more information, visit our website www.interfacegambiatv.com and buy your tickets now. Chief guest of honor, Usenu Jallo and family. Entertainment performance on that night, Big C. The Boss Mar. Tyrone the Prince. Ghana. Salo. London.
Ali be your life, girl. Summer hold me. Yeah, come on.
Daniel J. Survival. And Group Ngajfal family. InterFace Gambia TV 3 years anniversary dinner to be presented by Nyenya Dambell Musso, sponsored by Yaye Instant Services Limited. Don't miss it. InterFace Gambia on GRTS. A weekly TV program featuring
ñun wa InterFace Gambia fi ci Angleterre li len do won adina wongal cup ha huuro wa jëm na keng jajj war na mbam ah lu wedd gis bokko ca li nak dañuy enter ba paré fess bu ngon jotté ñu wonalé télé jëre gën jëf
programme diiné ji ak pencami ci GRTS lepp luy diiné fi ci bitim rew nak lañu dundé fi suñu diiné ak borom xam xam yi ay debate yu am solo ci wali diiné.
Host of Youth Ablaze with InterFace Gambia, make a date, don't miss it.
Battling Girl Show with me, Lady J, here on InterFace Gambia in London on GRTS.
I'll be bringing you Profile Show on InterFace Gambia on GRTS, giving you programs and activities in the United Kingdom, in Birmingham, Manchester and all other cities. We'll be profiling individuals, business people and organizations that are doing extraordinarily well in our society in the United Kingdom.
Every Sunday, 10:30 p.m.
Welcome back, and we're here with Sowe, a Gambian music producer who is also well known in the Gambian musical scene. He's produced a lot of musicians in the Gambia. Before the break, we were talking about his early days as a DJ in the United Kingdom and some of the cultural activities and initiatives that he's been part of in our community here in the UK. Sowe, before the break, you were mentioning cultural events that you were also, you were part of in organizing, and went on to talking about some of the issues, some of the problems that happened after, because there were some heydays when people used to enjoy, but it's no longer the case.
Well, it's unfortunate that you know things has to go that way, but that wasn't the plan. Trust me, because. You know, as the saying goes, when the fun stops, I don't think you need to continue doing anything else. Mm. At some stage, the fun stopped. That's why I actually
decided to get away from it.
Yeah, okay. For a while. But it's something that, you know, we can rectify. You know, at least for the future generation to benefit from, because we built a great platform here for them to do something, but we need to guide them to the right direction, and we do it wholeheartedly with good intentions and help them come through and then take over, because the community now
is bigger than anybody. Mm. It's bigger than one individual. It's bigger than Sowe or Jollof Arts or whoever. I think we should come together at some stage for the sake of the Gambian community, and then look for way forward. And you know, it doesn't take a lot to do that.
Okay, the way forward, somebody has to step up, obviously, to start the discussion and the talk about moving forward. Currently, the Gambian music scene, especially in the United Kingdom, promoters don't have much credibility at this moment, judging by the fact that last August there weren't many people happy about the way musical promotion, especially when promoters tell people that musician X is coming, it doesn't happen. And it happened more than once, and people have lost trust. And you know, you being someone who's been there before, and you know, what can you do to gain or tell those who've been promoting in your absence what they can do to gain people's trust again?
Well, I've been there myself, like you said. We've done very successful. We've done lots of successful shows, but we also failed in one or two. Okay. That's allowed.
What were the lessons that you learned from those?
Yeah,
if you might share that with us. And
yes, that's why this is where I'm coming. I think you need to organize yourself properly, and you have to go through the right channels. You know, it's always the case that you know, along the way, you know, you might fall off the rails a bit through false information that you getting from your friends or whoever, and then you end up you know, getting yourself into or mixing yourself with the wrong people. Mm. So, and this normally doesn't help. That's one. Two, they have to learn the rules of this country. Okay. You know, this is not like Europe. Like, you know, one particular visa I can take anywhere. You know, I think I found the UK the most difficult place to get your artists here to. Not only artists, but, you know, even to secure a visa for your friend or whoever, I find this place the hardest.
Yeah, basically, visa is an issue where most promoters don't normally do their homework properly.
Well, yes.
And, you know, Europe is not the same as, well, the Schengen countries, not the same as the United Kingdom. If you have a visa for France, you can go to any other part of the EU. But
yes,
if you don't have a visa to come to the United Kingdom,
mm-hmm,
you can't come in. This is where the promoters, some of them are getting wrong.
Well, I think visa is number one. Mm. You know, you have to secure work permit first, and then, you know, get all the necessary documents before you go to the embassy with the artist or whoever is coming. yeah, that's one big factor that where the promoters, the new promoters, do actually failed. And I believe, strongly believe in organizing your own camp and make sure that everything is in order before actually advertising.
Okay.
I know sometimes it's hard, but that should be the norm. Well, it's unfortunate because I do understand as well that, you know, you don't spend lots of money, like 20, 30, 40,000 pounds just for your show not to happen. It's rather unfortunate, and I wish them well, and I am open to support and help any promoter or anyone who is who wants to do these kind of events.
Your doors basically are open.
My doors are open. I can actually support and help. But, you know, expect reality. I'll tell you reality.
Okay. Well, that's it. Let's talk about you left the United Kingdom at some point and went back to the Gambia and set up Jollof Arts, and you're promoting a lot of Gambian music. Musicians back home, people like Jalimadi, people like Mandy Mori, Bai Babu. Tell us a little about those musicians, because they're rising stars at the moment. What have you been doing with them?
Yeah, exciting times are here for Gambian music. But let me take you back and then point of correction. Jollof Arts, I did not set it up now. Jollof arts was existing before I go to Gambia.
And you took it along?
I took it along.
Okay.
I took it because Jollof arts was responsible for doing Miss Senegambia UK here in the UK here.
Yeah.
And also all the other events that you actually hear us do, you know, were actually done through Jollof Arts.
Okay.
Jollof Arts, the label, because I've done it with partners, you know, who actually want to take it to another level. And actually, we think of setting up a record label and help the younger generation, point them to the right direction. And then maybe that can actually give them the platform that they need to succeed in the music industry. And then we share our experiences and then also open doors for them and then produce good quality music that can be sold in the outside world.
Talking of good quality music, we have a break with one of the musicians that Saul produced called Bai Babu. He's made a wonderful track called Chet Bissau. Let's have a watch. Welcome back. Bai Babu, Chet Bissau, produced by Saul, our guest here on of Jollof us in a studio here in London on the Profile Show. Now let's talk about Bai Babu. His Chepu Show is actually a very well taught music, and the clip is wonderful. And what is coming up with him? Is he producing an album, or this is just a track that he's done? What's happening with him?
I can tell you, this young man is the next big thing, and I think he already make big noise in Gambia. Mm-hmm. He is so doing well, I'm telling you. At this present moment, you know, I can't wait to go back to Gambia, because on the 18th of December, is finally it's here. Everybody is looking forward to that in Gambia. So I'm urging anyone who is coming from UK, Europe, all around the world, make it a date on the 18th. Ach Bachakow, Bai Babu. Mm-hmm. The most exciting talent that we have right now is about to drop an exciting album. You know, I produced the album, not because of I produce it, but I tell you, this kid is super talented.
Never lose his seat, come case what I'm a tube. You come give us access, the famine is a kutub. So my mind a blow to the highest altitude. You know, not Kureula, I love her attitude. I'll be got so answers, God is a whole like June. Come give up, never for bank, and they never for chukurut. Galaxies and galaxies hype, not from Tita to Pool. How about the language for words with a lot of a flu? Gawa soga, dah na fagata tondu. Fum roba boy you walis, we guess to taxi chibu. Jake le muna diju, suga na di sah di pidu. Dah to hinam agwa hinam, kum duga na yuhu. Kok di ko wahanto, dah kedam duka foyal to. Foko kis joko ceram sai sai duko gilem lo. Uta di feita men do minta nak duko puda ro. Hale bile gom bomba, dah mukoy puga ro. Hale bi gat sot ansas, karmi sa kholai chun. Kok giyeb na dafa banka, dede dafa chukurun. From Tita to Pool, how about the language for words sweeter than of a flu? You never for real, gawa bell, that I do hell with tail. You yaga harin, you go to one more than Musso. Munu go jade, and the glassy def jigain and hell. Kum see it naxa tutura unila baga wear the mail. Kuka habuton baga habko, boko hame sorry go. Kabari lai manatapale, yon si sako parigo. Kude gile si usi town me, kum hot in ak marigo. Kum see it ya your kanyi, mulai say nela let's go. Wapam la dal, buka na dala, meki gao ni bal. Fune bugalune kur ay pat mu dal helge dafa sap pencil gaw taw kur axel diga ñew te tula de delsil taxi mom bugu ci merci amul lay wax du tontu fi daf ko amul ak ken kum ci jage mu koy moytu ci ko la ñepp xale bi lene safal mo wax ci gatal do mu sa dega djegal su la nexe nak yokal comme kan nak sa djikola kou la nex ko xal
Kuma Nabati, Hol Bachakow, Jollof Ass 100. 18th of December.
Right. All right, 18th of December, make a date. Bye Babu is dropping an album in the Gambia, produced by Jollof Arts, and Saul is the main man behind Jollof Arts. And 18th of December, in the Gambia, make a date. Bye Babu is going to drop his album at Bachakau. I'm talking of albums, it's not only Bye Babu, you've also produced Jalimadi.
Yeah.
Jalimadi is you know, he's a Gambian musician who has a very, very wonderful voice. And you produce Jalimadi as well. And talking of productions, it's like you're on fire. Manding Mori's album Dokuolom is also produced by Soul. So if I am in the Gambia and want to, or here in the United Kingdom, and want to have an album of this, is it available on iTunes?
Yes, you can get it on iTunes. And you can also contact Serif Interface Gambia here, of course. To get these two albums. I think this represents Gambia to the fullest. Trust me, both of them are very diverse in the way they do their music. Mm. The fusion of this album tells the story of Gambia.
Okay, let's have a snapshot of some of the music that Mandy Mori and Jalimadi has done. Just a few clips of what they've done, and you will have a feel or a gist of what he's talking about.
Nalevo jarabi malo manyide imache kanule gemema
Kano na talumba nila.
Ay, ay, yeah.
fo ba tema fo nyenke ma la ta nyola
ye kanole a kanon kanona lelumba
kanon nyonkuba fela bina njonkula aye njonkunda ako nye mankulkula
oi kanone muna kanon
what's up
kanona lelumba
aye njonkunda ako nye mankulkula kanon nyonkuba Tema, then it for Batema. Chop, when you came out, Natanola,
ye canoe, a canoe,
canoe, canoe, Cuba, Fela Binan Jocula, Tay, and Jocunda, a quenya monkula,
canoe, Mona canoe,
what's up,
canoe,
and Jocunda, a quenya monkula, canoe, Cuba.
Right, Jalimadi and Mandy Mori, just a snapshot of the music that Saul has been explaining. They're rising stars in the Gambia, and it's all produced by Chol of Us. And Saul is also you know, a music promoter, and of course, he's been in the United Kingdom. And yes, let's backtrack a little bit with the promotion bit, because it's quite important. You've had some collaborators that you work with and in the Gambia, in the music industry here in the United Kingdom, post 1994, 1997, 1998. Who are those people?
Yeah, those, it started, well, when the carnival blew up in 94, 95, of course I did it with Waka for about 3-4 years. And then, I take a break and go to the Gambia.
Okay.
And then that's where Yaram Arts emerges. Njok Malik, and you know, he did fantastically well himself.
Yeah.
I must recognize that. And you know, also he actually created the cultural week again. This time, I think, in a different scale. And we all appreciate and recommend that as well. Waka